Students, it is the part 2 of the video which is related to the lesson The Rise of Christianity, the first lesson in history of class 7 ICSE. Come on, let us continue with our studies. Question number 17, why was Jesus crucified? The Jewish priest complained to Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor. He arrested charge on the false charge. What were the false charges? It comes next. The charge was that he called himself the King of Jews and encouraged the people to rebel against the Roman Empire. The other Jewish leaders made a false accusation, saying that Jesus was calling himself as the King of Jews, and also he encouraged people to fight against the Roman Empire itself. These were the false accusations. So as a result, he was sentenced to death. Then, where was Jesus crucified? Jesus was crucified in Golgotha. 19th question, how did the cross become the sacred symbol for the Christians? Answer, Jesus was crucified on the cross, thus the cross became the sacred symbol for the Christians. Next question, who is regarded as Jesus Christ's representative on earth? The Bishop of St. Peter's Church is regarded as Jesus Christ's representative on earth. He is called the Pope or Father. Even today, in the Vatican City, St. Peter's Church is there. It is the residence of the Pope. If we go there, we can meet him. In exercises, choose the correct answers. Number 1, which century marked the end of the medieval period in Europe? Answer, 16th. Second question, which place did the Romans conquer in the 1st century BCE? Answer, Palestine. Third one, the 4 short books from which we get to know about the life of Jesus are called the Gospels. Yes. The 4 Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Next one, the most famous sermon delivered by Jesus Christ. It is the Sermon on the Mount. Fifth one, Jesus was crucified in Das. Answer, Golgotha. Then section B, give reasons for the following. They give a sentence for which we are supposed to give the reasons. First question, Romans were not popular among Jews. Answer, in the middle of the 1st century BCE, the Romans conquered Palestine, the homeland of the Jews. Herod became the ruler and tortured and killed many Jews. This made the Romans unpopular. Second question, Jesus Christ earned a lot of followers. We need to give the reason. Answer is, Jesus was a great healer. He used to heal many people. He restored the sight of the blind and healed the sick. His simple lifestyle, his love and compassion towards people earned him a lot of followers. Then, section C, answer the following. It's a long answer type of question. Question number 1, what do you mean by the term medieval? The medieval period did not start at that same time all over the world. Explain. The word medieval comes from the Latin word medium aevum, which means middle age. The period that lies between the ancient and the modern periods is known as the medieval period. The changes from the ancient to the medieval period did not happen overnight. What does it mean? It means The changes haven't taken place all of a sudden. It took years, many years to happen. That's why they have said it did not happen overnight. In India, it is stretched from the 8th century to the 18th century. But in Europe, it is stretched from the 6th century to the 16th century. Next question. Describe the background against which Jesus Christ emerged as the preacher of the masses. Answer. In the middle of the 1st century BCE, the Romans conquered Palestine, the homeland of the Jews. Herod became the ruler. He tortured and killed many Jews. The Roman practice of worshipping emperors as gods angered the Jews further. It means, instead of worshipping the true God, the Romans used to worship their kings themselves as gods. It made the Jews more and more angry. So the Jews looked forward, they expected, to the coming of a Messiah. It means savior, who would liberate them from the foreign rule. So they didn't want to live as bonded laborers or in bondage. So they were expecting a Messiah, a savior that God would send to them to save them, to liberate them, to make them escape from the foreign rule. They also expected him to establish the kingdom of God. They had not only expected a Messiah to come and liberate them, but also they expected him to establish the kingdom of God. It was against this background Jesus Christ preached his message of love, brotherhood, and compassion and emerged as the preacher of masses. So in this background only, Jesus started preaching the message of love, brotherhood, and compassion. And he emerged as the preacher of masses. Third question, what do the Gospels tell us about Jesus Christ's life? Answer, the Gospels tell us that Jesus grew up in Nazareth. He followed his father's profession and became a carpenter. His father, named Joseph, he was a carpenter. So, following his father's work, he also became a carpenter. He left it soon and began preaching the message of love in the form of parables and sermons. What is meant by parables? Telling a story with comparisons. By comparing one thing with the other, he used to tell stories so that even the illiterate people, even the uneducated masses could easily able to understand. And sermons means preaching. He chose 12 apostles among his followers to help him spread the message of love and brotherhood. He had hundreds of followers. Among them, he chose only 12 apostles so that they would help him in spreading the message of love and brotherhood. Fourth question, what did Jesus Christ preach? Jesus Christ preached the message of love, brotherhood, and compassion. Fifth question, why was Jesus crucified? The Jewish priest complained to Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor. He arrested Jesus on the false charge. The charge was that he called himself the King of Jews and encouraged the people to rebel. Rebel means what? To fight against the Roman Empire. As a result, he was sentenced to death. Then section E, picture study. In this section, they would give a picture depicting a particular scene. From that, they ask a few questions. We need to answer accordingly. Here, first one, who ordered the crucifixion? Who ordered the crucifixion of Jesus Christ? The answer is, the Roman governor Pontius Pilate ordered the crucifixion. Second question, why did Christianity not fade away with the crucifixion of Jesus? What is the meaning of this question? Why did Christianity not disappear, not destroy with the crucifixion of Jesus? In other words, after Jesus was put to death. The answer is, many of Jesus' followers believed that Jesus rose from the dead and ascended to heaven. Many of Jesus' followers believed firmly that after the death of Christ, he rose from the dead and went up to heaven. They started preaching with more courage. The rising from the dead of Christ gave them more courage. So they started preaching with more courage. His disciples, notably Saint Peter, Saint John, and Saint Paul, converted many into Christianity. So Christianity did not fade away with the crucifixion of Jesus. It still thrives. So with this, this lesson has come to an end. We'll keep uploading the other lessons in the days to come. So don't forget to subscribe this channel. Don't forget to share it and click the bell icon to get more and more notifications.
Like, share and comment and subscribe our channel and click the bell button for more videos.